human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put your blame on me. Don't put your blame on me.
So it's Feb the 1st, and it's quite early in the morning, about 7, and it's been a big old snow dump. And so begins February, and my vlog, lots of travel, and I hope that it doesn't start with flight cancellations. Hello from New York. I have arrived. I'm just really, really feeling exhausted. And I've done a lot of travelling over the past few months. And it's just, I think it's catching up on me. I think I'm spinning so many plates with huge projects at the moment. And every single one of them are as important as the other. Huge decisions need to be made. And I'm feeling the pressure. I really am. It's all amazing. It's all exciting. It's positive. But I'm just really tired. I'm really frustrated with myself because I'm just not living the way that I know I need to feel better. I'm not eating as well as I should. I'm not exercising. I haven't exercised consistently now for probably close to 4 months. And I just can't seem to find the motivation and the dedication to doing it consistently. I just feel exhausted. And the pain is getting worse and worse every day that I'm not moving. I mean, the only good thing is I'm still sticking to doing around 10,000 steps a day, which is making everything bearable and my hip bearable. But I can feel my core getting weaker. I can feel my ability to cope with things getting harder. And I'm feeling it. And I've got to find the strength inside, mentally, physically. I've just got to find the strength.
So you all know who I am. I'm Laura.
Claire Francanano.
I'm Anthony Van Der Steen.
Rent Dalglish.
Woody Gandy.
And we have Carol and Angela from the Society team.
On the way back from the hypermobile gene network meeting, it went pretty well, huh?
Went great.
Really good. Loads covered. And watch out for some updates soon. Back at the hotel, made it out alive after our amazingly intense but very productive day with the hypermobile gene network. For those who don't know, the hypermobile gene network is a group of people that was put together after the Ehlers-Danlos Society got a donation of $1 million, which was incredible. And the purpose of the donation was to find what the genetic causes, so we think there'll be causes, are for hypermobile EDS. So what we're doing is we're whole genome sequencing 1,000 people from all over the world to see what the causes are. And there's lots that goes into this, IRBs, and lots of ethics and rules and lots of things that we need to do right. And I think the most heartwarming part of all of this is we've got incredible geneticists all around the table together that have been up to this point doing work individually and not really communicating on the scale that we're seeing now. And everyone is just so committed to collaborate. It's incredible. And so not just are we looking at these 1,000 whole genomes that we're gonna look at, but we're also, everyone has agreed to share the data of existing sequencing that has been done to create a global repository of all of the different whole exomes and whole genomes, which there aren't many, that have been done around the world, to reanalyze that together to see if we can find anything and have a starting point. So it's amazing, it's exciting. We're just at a time now where I think everything's just gonna explode and grow and develop, and it's just incredible to be a part of it. And by the time this comes out, we may have announced the recruitment plans. In case we haven't, I won't explain it yet, but the information is coming out very, very soon of how you can be part of this groundbreaking study. And I really believe that we're gonna know so much more. coming out of it. And something that would have been announced by the time this comes out is that we did a match, we did a call for a match for that $1 million because we needed another million to complete this. So the million covers the cost of whole genome sequencing 1,000 people. And then to do all the work surrounding it, build this repository, everything is gonna need another million. And we got it. So we got an incredible further donation of $1 million, which was actually from an anonymous donor in the UK who actually gave £1 million.
It's February the 11th, I believe, and I finally made it to the gym for the first time since last summer, which hurts my soul a little bit, but I did it, and that's what's most important. And it's been so hard psychologically to psych myself up to get there, because that's half the battle. I've had some physical things that have meant that I couldn't go, but not enough to be an excuse. And that's the thing with EDS, there's so many good excuses. You're exhausted, you're in pain, you know, everything in between. But frankly, the gym makes all of those things better. Every Monday I tell myself, this is the week I'm gonna go. It doesn't matter if I'm traveling, I'm gonna go. And then something, I'll be exhausted, I'll be in pain, I'll have a call, I'll have a meeting. And this morning I woke up and I walked Ripley, and I was in so much pain with my hip. I was limping, I was just like, this is agony. And I know what I need to do to make it feel better. So I came home and I took my proteins and my BCAA, which I'm gonna show you in a second, and I went to the gym. And it was amazing. And I feel so much better from it. And the best thing is because that's it. Now I'm gonna be going at least 4 times a week. I've still been doing my, on average, 10,000 steps a day. So that's why it's taken a longer time to decondition this time. But psychologically, I feel so much better. I feel energized, I'm proud of myself, and I feel good. And I'm just ready to get back in this routine of eating well, taking my supplements. So I've talked about this before. Every single day, I take this. I never skip this. This is like my medicine. And I take 2,500 milligrams, at least 5,000 milligrams when I'm feeling a little bit more tired or if I'm ill. And you take it in the powder form. I get mine from Holland & Barrett, but you can buy it anywhere. I've bought it in America before. The powder is the purest form, and it's also the best digested. So I always recommend the powder. Before I go to the gym, I take 5 grams of BCAA, and that helps with recovery. And I mix that and the Vicks together. So that's what I do with that. And then when I come back from the gym, like now, I then take another 5 grams of the BCAA, and then I take my protein, 25 grams. And that's what I do every time, and that really helps with recovery. It helps with kind of what you call the DOMS, which is what some people confuse with having an injury or pushing themselves. But anyone gets DOMS. It's delayed onset muscle soreness, and it feels like hell. Like when you climb the stairs, when you sit down, the pain in the muscles is intense, but that's a good pain. It means that your muscles have been torn a little bit, which means they're gonna build, which means they're gonna give you support, and they're gonna help all the bits of tissue that don't work so well. So I have a tear in my glute, a labral tear, a meniscus tear. Now, honestly, the gym doesn't really help my meniscus tear. It doesn't really help the pain, but it helps the pain so much with my glute and my labral tear because I'm strengthening the muscle around it. And I think it's because the meniscus is not muscle, so it's a different kind of injury. Both of them were spontaneous. I just kind of woke up one morning with them. The other thing that happened at the beginning of this year that was something that was unexpected is I was actually diagnosed with skin cancer. I had a lesion on my arm that I discovered towards the end of the year, and I was traveling so much and I kept ignoring it. And finally, my wife convinced me to go to the doctor, and I did. And literally, I think the 2nd of January, I got the results that it was skin cancer. They removed all of it. I no longer have it.
But I was very, very young to get the type that I did, and they think it was because of my immune deficiencies that I have with my EDS. So I'm now seeing an immunologist, and I may need to go on some medication to prevent more coming. But things like that you can't prepare for. Like, I never thought that skin cancer would be something that I might get as a result of my EDS. And maybe it's not, maybe it's totally unconnected and it was just bad luck. But they went quite deep. I was most worried because it was on my tattoo. So I was like, oh no, my tattoo's gonna be ruined. But they've given me the most amazing scar. In fact, you would never even know it's there. But they went quite deep, and so muscle stuff. And that was my January excuse. And then I was like, you know what? There's no more excuses. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna feel stronger and feel better. And I recommend everyone to find your thing that makes you feel stronger, feel happier, feel clearer in your mind. For me, it's the gym, other people it's swimming, other people it's whatever. I love the gym, I go there and I put on filthy hip hop and I just have a clear head and I do what I do. And I don't push myself. I'm gonna do a video of what I do in the gym and share that with you on this. But I think it's just important to keep this strong and this strong as much as you can.
Of music by Mr. Miles Davis, My Funny Valentine. Gotta love jazz, so I'm gonna share that with you each vlog as well. So happy Valentine's to all you lovers out there. Unfortunately, I can't take my wife out for dinner tonight because I'm here. It's quite a romantic city too, but she could not be here, alas, so I will take her out for the weekend. Proving the effectiveness of patient engagement. You know, we constantly say nothing about us without us, and I truly believe that that is the gold standard. But it's kind of anecdotal. We don't know if that's true. Is it beneficial? Does it help? Does it improve research? So this project is aiming to measure the effectiveness of patient engagement. So I'm really, really chuffed to be part of it. As an expert advisor, so we took part in the Delphi process, which is a way of kind of getting to what we think is the right answer. So it consisted of two online surveys, which is kind of asking you the same kind of questions to see if you can finally kind of get to the right answer. And then it's often concluded with a face-to-face, which is what we're here for today. So it's been great meeting other people, hearing other people's opinions, and seeing the dedication of this initiative to try and get a little bit more evidence to prove why it's so important to have patients around the table as equal stakeholders. On my way to New York City, the politics geek inside me is going crazy because I'm on my way for 2 days of meeting at the United Nations.
February is Rare Disease Month,
and next week is Rare Disease Day. And there's lots of events going on all over the world to celebrate this, and this is one of them. So massive geeking out on the whole political thing here. I am standing outside the United Nations, about to go in for the second high level event for the NGO Committee on Rare Diseases for the Rare Disease Policy event, and it's to celebrate the continuation of Rare Disease Month. So this is going to be pretty exciting. I've not been in this kind of meeting before in the UN. I'm sure I can't take my phone with me, but I will be sure to tell you all about it when I get out. United Nations. I felt so privileged to be there, absolutely exhausted. It was a really full-on few days, really jam-packed. So now I'm rushing to Penn Station to get the train to Baltimore for our four-day staff retreat. Let's go! Busy working away. I'm going to go around, everyone's going to tell you who they are. Excuse me, busy working. Can you just tell us who you are and what you do for the society?
I'm Angela Bowen, the Research and Registry Coordinator.
Hello.
I'm Alan Hackey, I'm the Director of Education.
Thank you very much. And who do we have around here?
Hello, I'm Chris, the Head of Farm Development Director.
Thank you.
Hello, I'm Shani Weber, and I'm the Patient and Community Advisor.
Thank you very much.
I'm Mark Martino, and I don't know what it is. Facebook website.
Yes, indeed. Here's our Swiss Army knife, indeed. Who do we have here?
Jack Annabelle, graphics and web designer, and serial talker.
I'm Jessica Adelman. I am Social Media and Communications Manager.
Hi guys, I'm
Stacey
Stevens, I'm event manager and
Echo Clinic Coordinator.
Hi, I'm Carol Everson, I'm the operations director.
Diddy, okay. So we're going to get back to work. Putting the world to right. And we forgot one other person. Who are you?
I'm Erin Simons, I'm communication consultant.
It's Oscar night.
From the United Nations to the Houses of Parliament. Arrived at the Houses of Parliament for Rare Disease Day and predictably mixed up in all kinds of crazy Brexit politics, people chanting and protesting. So hopefully politics can be put aside for the day and we can talk about rare diseases.
My
own experience with as an Ehlers-Danlos patient, I think has been entirely typical, and it has led me to my own conclusions about rare diseases policy. I was undiagnosed for 30 years, and I went through all the usual experiences of a diagnostic odyssey. I got very sick in childhood, I was referred to many doctors, they all tried their best, they ordered more and more complicated and invasive tests, but many ended up suggesting a psychiatrist, and others prescribed me some things that made me simply sicker. But finally, a wonderful neurologist who happens to have experience with EDS realised what had been going on and referred me to a specialist who diagnosed me in 20 minutes. 20 minutes after all those years. And over the next 18 months, I acquired a fleet of specialists. But initially, it was a disaster. As they started trying to find me the right medical regime, I got much, much sicker because I found that trying to coordinate all the tests and the appointments and the medications while still working was just impossible. I don't think that there is a flat surface on this building that I have not collapsed on, including this very podium when I was trying to give a speech on Rare Diseases Day a few years ago, and you've all very patient with me, so thank you very much.
So fantastic parliamentary reception. Incredible to hear our Minister of Health, Nicola Blackwood, talking about living with EDS up in Parliament. It was amazing. Now I'm trying to go home and I seem to have ended up in some kind of march. I still say, remain.
So, it's Rare Disease Day. The 28th of February and also the end of the month, and it's been an insane one. I'm absolutely exhausted. You can see I'm wrapped up, I'm feeling a bit meh. It's been relentless, lots of different countries, lots of different meetings, so much going on for Rare Disease Month. Yesterday was fantastic in House of Parliament, meeting Baroness Nicola Blackwood, and then the United Nations, and then sandwiched in between that we had our incredible staff retreat with new members of staff, and it's been amazing. I'm inspired, I'm exhausted, but I'm ready for the year ahead. We've got so much we're announcing, we've got so many different events, we're going to be everywhere, we're going to be in so many different places all over the world, and it's really great to have you guys alongside me now with this vlog. So keep leaving comments of things that you want to see. I'm aware that people want to see what I do at the gym, and I just haven't had time to get someone down with me to the gym to film me because it's really awkward doing a gym routine with a selfie stick. So I will do that. Next month is equally as busy. It's also my birthday. It's my wife's birthday. It's my sister's birthday. It's my mum's birthday. So many birthdays. March is a fun-filled month. So it's also my wife's 30th this year. So it's a pretty special one. And it's my sister-in-law's wedding this weekend. So starting March with a bang. Really exciting stuff, both work-wise and for me as well, with the wedding, birthdays and everything else. But I've got to keep pacing. I've got to find some more spoons and keep going. But it's an exciting time and it's a positive time. And I'm glad that I get to share it with you. Till next time.